Almost every company has to deal with a periodic financial close. A lot of tasks need to be executed in a short period of time. One of these tasks is to match the intercompany receivables and payables. Do you have the feeling that this task is not as efficient and takes up more time than you would like? Then this video is exactly what you're looking for. Hello all. My name is Bas de Graauw and I'm a finance consultant at McCoy Partners. In order to streamline the process of intercompany matching, SAP provides a solution called Intercompany Matching and Reconciliation. This solution is embedded in the S4HANA system and helps you to get a quick overview of the matched items, and more important, it helps you to focus on the exceptions so that you know where to take action. It can be used without the need for any additional licenses. Within the group, companies can sell products and services to each other and send each other invoices. These invoices need to be processed on both sides, the sending company and the receiving company. In this picture, with just two companies and one invoice, it is easy to check. But what happens if the number of invoices is a lot more? Or the number of partners within the group selling to each other is a lot bigger? Or partners do not only buy from each other, but also to sell to each other? How can you easily identify for which invoices there is an issue and which need to be corrected? SAP Intercompany Matching and Reconciliation can help with that. In this demo, I would like to show three apps. We will start with the reconciliation status overview, and from there, we will navigate to a more detailed layer. From within this first app, we can open the other two apps. The first app is called the Reconciliation Status Overview. You get an overview of the companies within your group with an indicator that shows the reconciliation status balance and the matching status. The matching status tells you how many non-assigned invoices there are. So this one is based on the number of invoices. The reconciliation balance status tells you what the balance is for each combination of partner unit and currency. For each of these combinations, a color is determined. Green means it is an exact match. Yellow means it's not an exact match, but the difference is still within the tolerance limits. Red means it's not an exact match, and the difference is outside of the tolerance limits. New postings that are made in the system are detected automatically. There is no additional effort needed to make the data available for this module. You can use the dashboard as a starting point, and you can click further for more details. So let's focus on the lowest line, company 3710. When we click further, we come into the second app, the Reconciliation Balances app. This app provides you with a total overview of the intercompany balances. This overview shows the intercompany balance by different partners and currencies. And you get an indication of the difference. For company 3710, you can see that it has outstanding invoices with two different partners, and that for one of the partners, business is done in two different currencies. The difference column shows the difference in balance, and the colors have the same meaning as you saw in the dashboard. So let's focus on the first line where we have a small difference. From here, we can click further to more details. And when we do that, we come into the third app, which is called the Manage Assignment app. This screen is built up into three sections. The lowest section contains all the invoices that are matched. The top section contains all the open non-assigned invoices. On the left, we have the invoices from our leading company, in our case, 3710. And on the right, we have the invoices on the partner company. As you can see, there are two invoices for which the amount do not exactly match. And there are two items that are only present in the partner company. For the two items that do not have the same amount, we can still assign them manually and accept the difference. The system can support you in automatically posting these differences. You make the manual assignments by selecting the items and clicking on the Assign button. A pop-up appears where you can fill in the reason code, which indicates what kind of match it is, and in this case, we also have to supply a comment. After clicking Assign, the items are moved to the lower section of the screen. For the other two items that are still not assigned, we need to take additional action. But that is beyond the scope of this video. So let's go one step back to the overview and focus on one of the other lines. When we go to the details, you can see that there are no non-assigned invoices and that all the invoices are matched. This is the ideal situation where you would like to get to. As you can see, SAP helps you to focus on the exceptions, indicating where actions are needed. Once action is taken, the screen should look like this, so that you know that your intercompany balances match and both companies are completely aligned. After that, you can successfully close this task of the month-end process. If you would like to know more on this functionality or any other functionalities to streamline your month-end process, McCoy is more than happy to get in touch with you. So please reach out to me or to one of my colleagues if you would like to meet and discuss the possibilities for your organization. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next one.